guys, thank you so much for tuning in and clicking on this video. It's the latest on trend with your girl Biami.
Big up business.
People, we are officially in gear Casa Amor. The Casa Amor villa are literally taking this thing seriously. It's really annoying though how the main villa are just being so loyal and just like boring. And I feel sorry for the guys, man, because the ladies are not feeling it at all. All they're doing is thinking about their boys and all sorts, whatever. Before we get into this, who appointed Jake Captain Casa Amor, please? Who appointed him team leader? Who appointed him manager? And the advice he's given the guys as well, like, my guy, just sit down, please, and go and lay down somewhere and think about your Libby, because I'm so over him. Like, I'm actually over him with his advice and just going around planting seeds. Like, he's actually being very strategic. Like I said before, I would never want my man to have this type of friend. He's the type of friend you don't want your man to have. Like, legit, legit, legit. So, they had the games, the Casa Amor game, where the Casa Amor villa and the main villa go head to head. And of course, this really stirs up things because people start thinking things and they're like, oh my gosh, he's the shortest guy. He kissed this. Why were they the fastest? And all sorts and all that. So it stirs up the pot a little bit, which is what we like because we want to see a bit of action. Let's quickly talk about some of the guys in Casa Amor, because heads are getting turned, heads are getting scrambled. It's a mess. Like, it is a mess, and I'm starting to have doubts. I strongly believed in Liam. I was just like, yes, Liam and Teddy. But now I'm like, oh, I don't know, man. Liam, he's a naughty boy. You could tell he's a naughty boy. It wouldn't take him much for him to be seduced. Like, you can tell. Like, he'd be one of them ones where it's just like, oh, let me just do it, innit? Let me just do it and let me just face the consequences. He's one of them ones. Whereas with Teddy, he's a bit more calculated. He's like, is this really worth? I don't know. Whereas with Liam, he's just like coming into the lines dead, isn't he? He's just like freely walking in. Like, he's like, eat me up. He's literally just walking in like, eat me up, mate. Like, listen, it's Casa Amor and this is what I'm here to do. I'm 50-50 with him. Not really 50-50, but I have a little bit of hope. But that Lily, she's really laying it down. And I don't know, man. I don't know. For entertainment purposes, it's good. Because it's like, oh, imagine if he actually comes back with Lily. He could actually do it, guys. Like, he could legit do it. He could actually do that to our Millie. Nah. I don't know. Now, Teddy, on the other hand, Teddy and Clarice. I like Clarice. See, I like Clarice's personality. I like Clarice. I don't know what's happened to Salma. They've muted her. You guys remember Rachel? She's giving me another version of Rachel. Like, Rachel came in with this confidence. Same with Salma, with this confidence, this sass. Everybody was like talking about her. There was a buzz around Salma. She got into the villa and then she got muted. I don't know whether she felt intimidated. You know, sometimes with pretty girls, it's like they're not used to being around a lot of other pretty people, or they're only used to being the center of attention. And then when they're around other people that get more attention, they kind of close up. It's like their insecurities get heightened up and they don't know how to function. And then they kind of lose the sass, they lose that fire. I feel like that's almost what's happened. It's like, even during the challenges, she's comes across a bit timid. Like, I feel like she feels overwhelmed and she's not used to not getting the attention. You know, you're not seeing her personality, she's not moving to anybody. Like, and I think maybe that's why she's not getting airtime, because she's not giving the storyline. Like, she should just go in there, speak to Teddy, speak to Tyler, speak to whoever you want to speak to. Speak to that boy that needs to leave. What's his name? Toby. Like, just speak to the guys, man. Oh, I really, really wish that, oh, I keep forgetting his name, the black guy was in that villa, because I feel like maybe he would be attracted to her. But then again, I personally think that she feels overwhelmed by the beauty around her. She's not used to having that this level of competition around her. Like, maybe she was the leader in her friendship group, or maybe she's always used to getting a lot of attention. Obviously, she's been on social media, she gets a lot of likes, a lot of love, so she's used to people pumping that into her. You know what I mean? So anyways, I like Clarice. She's got a great personality, she's got a great buzz around her, and I like this thing that she's got with Tyler. Now, is she better suited for Tyler? I feel like her and Faye are both Tyler's type, even though they're extremely different. But I would like him to get with Clarice. But I feel like long term, him and Faye would last longer, if that makes sense. I don't know. Like, I like him and Faye. I'm just like, you know what? Just stay with Faye, because you guys have actually something genuine going on. And it's, I like it. I like what they have. To me, it feels authentic. It feels genuine. And yeah, I like seeing them together. Now, Tyler, on the other hand, baby, he wants Clarice. And he wants Clarice and he wants the other girl. I don't know her name. Is she Asian? I don't know her name, but I don't know why Hugo was going for her, because it looked like she had lip fillers to me. Maybe she looks like she's got her boobs done. And I didn't think he liked fake, but apparently that's his type. I was very surprised by that. Not that there's anything wrong with her. I think she's actually pretty. I actually prefer her without makeup. When she had makeup, it looked a bit too much. I didn't like that. She actually looked, to me, better without makeup. But I did not think that that was Hugo's type, which is very strange. But Hugo is just getting... My guy is getting swerved, mate. He ain't gonna get no gal, yeah? He ain't gonna get no nothing. He's gonna get back into that villa alone, or a girl is gonna realize, snap, I need to get back into the main villa, so let me just stick this on him. But he's not gonna find love. Hugo needs to leave now. It's his time to go. Or do they do it like, if they nobody picks them, then they get dumped as well? I don't know, but I feel like Hugo is next to go. He needs to go anyway. Toby, I don't even want to talk about him anymore. He's just annoying me. He's doing Love Island how Love Island is purposed for, if that even makes sense. Basically, he's just doing rabbit hopping. The way he's talking about Abigail, I was like, bro, you literally had that massive fallout with people in the villa for Abigail, because the choice that you made for Abigail. And then he has the audacity to say, if this was the connection that I had with Chloe, then I wouldn't be doing this. So you left a good connection to go with somebody that you just had a little fling with. That does not even make sense, bro. Like, that doesn't... Oh, Toby. Toby, please. I don't want to see him anymore. He doesn't even give me the same way. He gives me annoyance. He's annoying. So you're out here declaring that you had a deep connection with Chloe, but you left Chloe for Abigail, that you don't consider, you don't care about. Wow, what a guy. I am so disappointed in Kaz, and I'm not saying that she has to fancy a black guy or whatever, but she looks good with Mehdi, man. And I'm just like, I'm just like, it's so, like, the main villa are really boring me. And Chloe just doing the rounds, and the way she's talking to the boys, like, her confidence is, like, way too much. She's not even looking for love anymore at this point. Her true colours have come out. I don't know how we're going to find a way to boot her off, but she needs to come off now. But, yeah, tonight is going to be... I can't wait to see what's going to happen. At this point, Liam is keeping us on our toes. And we're just like, Liam, man, you're going to kiss this girl. Like, you're actually going to kiss this girl. But I'm going to say, no, Liam, he's going to go back to Millie. He will. He's going to play a little bit. Yes, he will. Because he's a naughty boy. Naughty. He's a naughty big boy, isn't he? But he's going to stay. He's going to go back to Millie. He really is. Oh, my God. Don't disappoint me, boy. You better not disappoint me. Anyways, let me know your predictions, guys. Thank you for tuning in. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button and I'll speak to you guys in my next video.
Don't forget to hit your notification bell so that you guys are notified whenever I post